about time to start. We're small but mighty this morning.
That's right. Have you been able to hook into the Wi-Fi?
Monica did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we did yesterday.
Yeah.
Do you mean right now or?
Yeah, because I think we just got the extender back and I just plugged it in here.
Yeah, that's the one Roku's working on, folks.
I just plugged it in this morning, though.
Okay, I just fired it up this morning. So, yeah.
Okay.
We'll see.
Okay.
So, welcome back to The Power to Change. We're back to week 4 of our study on The Power to Change. And I just wanted, Steve, you shared a few things with me about everything that's gone on with the blessings that Jackie has seen. And I just, when we talk about asking, how did you see God at work? You've got a lot to say, and I would love for you to share.
Oh, so that's why I was handed the microphone here.
He's tricky.
Yeah, he is tricky. Our family has seen God at work this week quite a bit. Jackie's father died on Monday, and he was suffering from something called supranuclear palsy, which parts of his body were shutting down from the effects of misfolded proteins. And the last thing to shut down was his ability to eat and his digestive system, but his brain never shut down. We saw God at work through the prayers of the saints. We felt totally covered in prayer the last couple of weeks. We were brought lots of food here in the States. And Jackie was remarkably able to get over to Germany. She still had her German citizenship, so she was able to get over to Germany. She had a flight. She tried to get a flight that was a very, very expensive flight. And when she clicked on it, it was canceled. And the next morning, another flight appeared that was half the price.
Oh, wow.
And it was 3 days earlier. And she was able to get in to Germany on the last day that her father could communicate with her by squeezing her hand. So that 3 days was really critical. The greatest news of all was that she was able to, again, share her faith with her father. And she has the confidence that her father accepted Christ before he died, which we are humbled and praising God for. Another God sighting was the last time Jackie was in Germany. It was about a year ago. We were there a little over a year ago as a family, but she was able to go over again. And when she went over, she was able to help her father find there was an opening. They were on a waiting list for, I think, a year and a half, for an opening for a care facility for him. During that time, her mother was taking care of him and taking him up 6 flights of stairs when he could hardly balance. So it was really worrisome. To make a long story short, the care facility that opened up while she was there was a Christian care facility, which is unusual in Germany, in that part of Germany, really unusual. They cared for him, and they really showed their faith. We could not believe how well he was cared for there. And when he died, they honored his body and honored the family in a way that was so Christ-like. It was unbelievable. And as a result, I think, you know, through all these prayers and that, Jackie's family has been opened up to receiving her faith in a way that we haven't seen before. So her brother, who has always been quite critical of the faith, her faith, our faith, sat down and just asked her about her faith for over an hour without saying anything, just asking questions. And her mother was much more open. So we saw God's hands all over this, and we praise God for that. It was a great week in that. Yeah.
Thank you for sharing that. Good news all around. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, you are so good to us all the time. You bring us good things that sometimes we are almost oblivious to, and other times you come screaming through with things like a father that has accepted you as his Savior just in time. And we thank and praise you for that. We thank you and praise you for all of the sightings that the Rolf family has experienced over through this illness of her dad's. And we pray that you would continue to open those hearts that have begun to open. And now we pray that you would send your Holy Spirit right here to work in our hearts as we explore a little bit more the power to change that you have given to us. In these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So, in recapping the first 3 weeks of our, three weeks of our study, we learned in week one that the power to change comes from the Holy Spirit, who works from the inside out, works in us, in a process that we call sanctification. Unlike salvation and justification, sanctification is a slow process. We had a really beautiful analogy, a word picture from Steve and Jackie about clay and about how clay takes working and working and working, and it has this memory that wants to go back, just like we have this memory that wants to go back, and God is very patient and works through us in that way. 1 Timothy 4:7 through 8 says that while bodily training is of some value, godliness is of value in every way, as it holds promise for the present life and also for the life to come. And I kind of like that bodily training, yep, it's really great for our body, but the godliness is good for our whole self and for now and for eternity. In week two, we explored the idea of spending time with God in prayer and reading of his word. Not so much out of a sense of obligation, but out of a love and desire to know him more. God seeks relationship with us. And Romans 12:2 says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. And it's one of the ways we renew our mind is through spending time in the word and in prayer. Week three brought us to the idea of confession, confessing our sins to God and to others. We saw that Adam and Eve started it all by trying to hide from God in the garden. 1 John 1:9, God invites us to confess. Romans 8:1 tells us that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. And when we looked at Psalm 32, it showed us that there is freedom after confession. We also learned that repentance and confession are ongoing for life. So someone very near and dear to me, after we had that session three, said, so I was wondering why they would add confession to a story, to a study about the power to change. And I think that the video presentation showed us that we can't hide from God. One reason why confession is important to the power to change is that sin separates us from God. Satan prefers us to be alone in our sins, and that gives him all the power when he can keep us alone in our sin. But through confession, the sanctification process can move forward. Did I miss anything? Is there something, anything else, somebody that really touched somebody out of those previous weeks? So I think you're up to introduce the next one.
Okay. Good morning. We've got the B team now for the main part of, main part of today. And this week we're going to dive deeper, as they say in the Leader's Guide, into why our local church, in other words, Luther Memorial, and perhaps River Falls community, but also the Spirit-filled community that we're in, matters to our growth spiritually, but also on our ability to join Jesus on his mission. So before we watch the video, just a couple of questions. We'll have maybe a little interaction right now, but then we'll probably go back and address them again after the video. So first question, do we as human beings need and want to be together? Sally says yes.
Sometimes.
It depends on who.
Leo's more of a realist, sometimes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you think we were created and designed to be solitary creatures or community creatures?
Community.
I mean, remember, initially there were only, what, one? And then he saw that the guys were really lonely, so then we had two that came along, okay? So, do you think we were created to be solitary or community? Community, community, community. I'll go along with you. Shifting gears a little bit. Definition of a healthy church. Or characteristics of a healthy church. And don't bring up the fact that we atomize after the stuff like that.
Well, they love God.
They love God. Okay.
Lack of gossip.
Lack of gossip. Remember, we didn't say perfect church. You know, we said healthy church. So lack, not absence of. That's good. Okay, yeah. All right.
Love for each other. Love for each other.
Love for each other. Okay. Ellen.
A church that reaches out into the community, not just inside their building.
Outreach of the church itself, going out the front doors, not just staying within the doors and the walls, okay? This is one, we probably don't need any response back on this because this is kind of internal, but it gives you something to think about during the video. How passionate are you about our church? Not LCMS, not the Christian church, about Luther Memorial. How passionate are you about that? And the last question that we want to come up with and be thinking about a little bit while we watch the video is, how reliant are you on yourself? Vice others. How reliant are you on yourself instead of others? So with that, we're going to watch the video. For the folks at home, this is where you get on and you shift gears and you go into either IFE or you go into Right Now Media and you access Power to Change video. This is week 4. Depending on what Monica does with this or what I can get done with it today, there may be 2 videos today. One is prior to the video, and one is after the video. Might make it easier for you. So with that, we're going to